Are teams of co-working humanoids the next big shift in labor? Today on AI News, we're looking at the newest V3 robot with several next-gen hardware specs and abilities. Plus, stick to the end to see what's being called the best AI model ever. But before we get into that, Sharpa claims their newest robot hand just made a breakthrough in dexterity, and they proved it in this Thanksgiving demo. So this is the SharpaWave hand. It features this 1-to-1 human-like scale and 22 active degrees of freedom throughout. And in just a second, I'm going to show you what happens when you combine multiple hands to work together through multiple robots. But this hand specifically features a dynamic tactile sensing array, and it has these sensors in the fingertips, and each of its fingers can exert up to 20 newtons of force. But it's also been trained over 1 million times in simulation to be able to detect any type of surface or grip that it needs to modularly interact with its environment. And this is very important with what I'm about to show you with fleets of robots working together. But so far, you can see how this robot can grab all different types of objects and adjust for its force between hard objects like this cell phone here or soft objects like plastic or pieces of food, etc. And this is quite interesting because so far we haven't seen too many robots that can actually do things in the real world realistically, but we're about to get into what happens when a robot is commanded to do something without human input. So far with the SharpaWave, this is performing tasks that it's been trained on. But what happens when you combine multiple hands between a team of humanoids with zero human input? Well, in a new demonstration, two MenteeBot V3 units worked side by side to complete a full logistics task autonomously. This was with no teleoperation, no human guidance. And the robots picked up boxes and stacked them from varying heights, and then they placed them across multiple storage racks, and they coordinated their movements with each other. And the demo showcases here more than just picking and placing as we've seen before, because it actually highlights this stable locomotion and precise manipulation between robots interacting with real-time decision-making as they work with different physical objects in an unscripted environment. And for warehouse automation, this kind of coordinated autonomy could reshape how repetitive tasks get handled. So the MenteeBot stands at 175 centimeters tall, which is about 5 feet 9 inches. And it weighs 70 kilograms, or about 154 pounds. And in terms of speed, it can move it up to 1.5 meters per second, or just under 5 feet. And it features 40 degrees of freedom throughout its body, which provides this next level flexibility for complex movements throughout its working space. And the robot is actually able to carry up to 25 kilograms or 55 pounds of max capacity per load. And this is practical for most warehouse-like box handling scenarios. But the hands deserve attention here because MenteeBot claims that they handle everything from power tools to fragile objects, and they combine a firm grip with a delicate touch for more precise placements. And this balance between strength and gentleness has been one of the trickier challenges in robotic manipulation until now. And for power, it features a hot swappable battery, meaning that it can continuously operate 24 hours a day without downtime as long as you swap out the battery. And it also supports voice interaction, which allows workers to communicate with the robot directly as if it were a human. And in terms of the robot's software architecture, its approach deliberately avoids end-to-end vision language action models, which the company describes as brittle and compute-heavy. So instead, their modular architecture combines three elements. The first is pre-trained models for perception and language understanding. Second, there's reinforcement learning control policies that are trained using sim-to-real techniques. And third is their robotic API language that's powered by this large language model that breaks down complex tasks into more manageable steps with built-in error handling. And this modularity aims to solve a persistent problem, which is bridging the gap between impressive research demos and robots that can actually work reliably in customer environments. So the bigger picture here is having these MenteeBot humanoids work together like humans to be able to complete these overall long horizon tasks without human oversight or input. And it really comes down to the question of what is going to be the cost of these robots. Will they be cheaper than a human on a per year basis? But would you trust this robot to run in your home or office? And what are the tasks that you'd require it to do out of the box in order to justify these kinds of costs? Next, in generative AI, Anthropic's newest Opus 4.5 just topped benchmarks across multiple domains. But they say raw performance only tells a part of the story, as internal testers reported something even harder to measure, which is that the model simply gets it, meaning that it handles ambiguity and complex trade-offs without handholding like before. And according to the numbers, Opus 4.5 leads on real-world software engineering tests and outperforms competitors in reasoning, mathematics, and vision tasks. But perhaps the most impressive of all is that Anthropic gave the model a notoriously difficult engineering take-home exam, and within the two-hour time limit, Opus 4.5 scored higher than any human candidate ever has. And on top of this, it's smarter, not just faster. That's because Opus 4.5 uses dramatically fewer tokens than previous models to reach similar or better results. And a new effort parameter lets developers choose between speed and depth depending on the task. For instance, in a medium effort, it matches Sonnet 4.5's best coding scores while using 76% fewer output tokens. And in terms of safety, Anthropic calls Opus 4.5 their most robustly aligned model yet, and possibly the best aligned frontier model from any developer, because it shows improved resistance to prompt injection attacks, and Opus 4.5 is live now across Claude apps, the API, and major cloud platforms, with pricing at $5 per million input tokens and $25 per million output tokens, which is significantly cheaper than previous flagship models. And finally, Black Forest Labs just dropped Flux 2, a new image generation family that lets users feed in up to 10 reference images simultaneously, keeping characters, products, and visual styles consistent across outputs. And the models support resolutions of up to 4 megapixels and feature reworked text rendering for cleaner typography, infographics, and UI mockups. Plus, prompt adherence has also improved, particularly for complex compositions. And under the hood, Flux runs on a hybrid architecture pairing Mistral 324B, a vision language model that interprets text and input images, with a rectified flow transformer handling layout and detail accuracy. And it comes in 4 flavors. It spans between Flux 2 Pro, targeting top-tier quality. Then there's Flex, which offers developers control over speed and quality trade-offs. Next, there's Dev, which provides the open weights for the 32 billion parameter model, and Client, which is coming soon under the Apache 2.0 license, which aims to outperform similar-sized competitors. Anyways, like and subscribe, and check out the Ollie robot walking over things here.